Hi everybody, welcome to another Dan Live Q&A. I'm Sabrina Rodriguez and I'm really excited to be here today with the global CEO of Isobar, Gene Lin. We'll be talking about AI and creativity and how it transforms business. And it's just over a month away now from Cannes Lions. We've got a very exciting session lined up with Gene Lin and Wei Liu, the director of the AI lab at Tencent. And they'll be talking about the effect of AI on how we conceive ideas, how creativity is delivered, and ultimately what that creative future might look like. So in the lead up to that session, we'll be talking about how, as we enter this new era of machine learning, how AI is set to transform the way that agencies create experiences for brands, people, and businesses. So thank you very much for joining us, Dean.
Thank you, Sabrina.
Do you want to tell us a little bit more about where we are today in Isobar's Now Lab?
Yeah, so we're in London. We're actually sitting inside Isobar's Now Lab. So Now Lab is a global innovation accelerator for Isobar. We have virtual and physical spaces around the world that help our people to contribute to innovating and prototyping to solve our clients' issues. So here in London, in Now Lab, actually we had quite a good focus on retail, last mile, and commerce innovation. So here you can see things from shopping mirror that's interactive, to VR, to the link with Echo at Amazon. How you can create a voice-generated machine actually help to enable better shopping experiences. So this is one of the things that we share around the world, and people can work with people at Isobar around the world to accelerate the innovation. So, you know, we have Now Lab in China as well. So what you're mentioning about the Cannes Lions session, one of the things that our China Now Lab is doing right now is working with Tencent to focus on exploring a bit of how AI empowered creativity. And there are many exciting ideas there that we're prototyping and try to see how we can move the industry forward.
Brilliant. I know there's lots of props you can see behind us here. We've got some interesting headsets and VR headsets. We've got a smart mirror at the back. It's an amazing lab, so I'm really excited to be here. To anyone who's just joined us, we're here with the global CEO of Isobar, Gene Lin, and we're talking about AI and creativity in transforming business ahead of the event at Cannes Lions on the 19th of June, where Gene Lin will be talking with Wei Liu, the director of the AI lab at Tencent, on AI and creativity. So if you do have any questions for Gene, send them through and we'll do our best to answer them for you. Gene, it's obviously a very exciting session coming up at Cannes. Can you tell us a little bit more about Isobar's relationship with Tencent?
So Tencent actually, I mean, I was joking with Sabrina just now, this is my life. And my life in China depended on WeChat, which is a very important thing that Tencent developed. But Tencent is actually more than just a social media company. It is living with the motto of actually connecting everything. So from content entertainment to social network to QQ, which is their instant messenger, to WeChat, to mobile payment, to commerce, to linking online offline store experiences, Tencent is really, it's like an operating system for operating systems, because it works on both iOS and Android. Mm. It actually helps you to create that link with everything in your life. Yeah. So we have quite a strong relationship with Tencent. Similarly, we have a lot of innovation project going on with all the global media partners. But with Tencent, they're a data project they're working on in how we can create better targeted, for example, advertising to Tencent and WeChat users. And for this one, what we're trying to do is to create the innovation drive to see how we can really transform the creative businesses. So we're recently working quite closely with their innovation lab. And it is fascinating because one of the things that their innovation lab is imagining is looking at the world as a computer. So it's like, how interesting could that be? But actually how real that is right now with digital interpinning everything of human experiences that we're living our life that we cannot do without computing power and really digital. So that's part of it that we're trying to review in Cannes. you have to join the session to know more. I'm not allowed to tell you more than what you can know from the synopsis right now, but it's going to be really interesting, the life that we're walking into.
Yeah, it's going to be a fascinating session. So this is just a taster of what's to come. And Jean, how is AI affecting creativity per se? How is it impacting that whole area?
I think that, the fact that digital has become the center underpinning all human experiences, one key thing is the massive amount of data that you can collect through multiple devices. And it's impossible for any human being to interpret the massive amount of data in a meaningful way, like what we can do 50 years ago when advertising started to become something that's connecting brand and consumer. So AI is playing a very important role to help us really interpret the consumer life a lot better. So they're almost, it's like data is the part that empowered machine learning and AI. It helps us to look at a lot of conversational data to ensure that we understand consumer real time in the right way. It actually helps us to drive better insights into creativity and ideas and how powerful that can be when you want to be meaningful as a brand and business in consumers' life. So I think there are really two parts of this. One part is while you were developing the idea, how AI really empowered the creative thinker and strategist to think of the problem and challenge in a different way. The second part about it is how you actually create efficient interface to ensure that you activate creativity in a different way once the idea is conceived. So it's something massive is gonna change the entire creative industry.
Yeah, it affects the entire creative process right from beginning to end. Thanks to anyone who's just joined us. I'm joined here today by the global CEO of Isobar, and we're talking about AI and creativity and how it transforms business both now and in the future. So if you do have any questions for Jean, do send them through and we'll do our best to answer them for you. Machine learning, is a word that's thrown around a lot these days. How do you see it playing a role in digital transformation for big brands, for example?
I think we need to go back to what digital transformation really is. To me, digital transformation is a way that we can unlock the potential of an organization through digital technology. And digital technology has become so important today for any businesses that try to be successful in today's digital age. And what I feel that is critical for digital transformation and how you unlock the power is really how you can evolve your organization to become more consumer relevant and always evolving yourself because the business model has an expiration date. And what you have to do is to really harness the power of your organization to embrace and service your customer a lot better. That's where I think machine learning can play a critical role in understanding the customer real time. And right now, there are a lot of predictive modeling has been created to help brands to using simple machine learning tools that help you understand your customer better. But it can actually be done in such a proactive manner. And with simple things that you can do, you can improve the customer experience in a way that has never been done before. So for example, I think there is a project that our US team working with Google about. It's really to use machine learning to scan all the social data, the logs, the online forum, the chat history, to figure out where could be the breakout point for certain hardware. So when you are tip up the problem before it happens, actually you can help to fix the bug behind the scene and push that to the device before it became a customer service and repair nightmare.
Yeah.
And that type of proactive attitude is, I think, what it cannot be done before the age of machine learning. There's no way you can really get access and understand those consumer conversation in a meaningful way before. But right now, what you can do is to be a responsible brand and business. Using the power of machine learning, you can be so creative in the way you solve a customer's challenge.
Yeah, brilliant. And for anyone who wants to hear more about AI and creativity and how it transforms business, then do tune in for the event at Cannes Lions on the 19th of June with Wei Liu, who is the director of the AI lab at Tencent, who will be joining Jean Lin on the Palais stage. It'll be a fascinating session, so I do encourage you, if you are able to attend, to tune in. So how is AI then impacting creativity at Isobar in particular? It's obviously impacting the industry and brands as a whole, but how is it impacting what you do as an agency?
So as we just briefly talked about, I think the way I look at it is we're a creative agency in the digital age. So the key thing is about idea and how idea actually impacting the brand building and business building process. So the way that AI play a role is before the idea, actually data and AI help to augment creativity because you'll be able to look at the consumer's role in such a way that is very different, very real time, and you can create the real understanding. So in the creative development processes, this is something that actually helps us become better strategists and understanding the customer better to create and generate bigger ideas. And the second part is when idea is born, how you can personalize and activate the creativity much more with data and with the fact that you understand how you respond to clients' need real time. So I think these are the two buckets. The creativity actually could be generated in such a different way. And it's obviously very early in the application of AI in the creative process, if you look at it from the end-to-end journey. But we're doing more and more right now at Isobar using AI and machine learning to help us augment and activate creativity. So for example, we did a lot of work for GM, and all the banners that GM creates with thousands of occasions and targeting at different segments of people. Now with AI machine learning, what we can do is to create, after the idea is conceived, we can pick up the weather, the demographic, the user journey, and create combinations so that we generate more relevant ads for the customers to look at. So it's not an intrusion to consumers' life, rather it's arriving at your desk at the right moment, at the right time, it's the right place.
It's really convenience and relevance, I suppose.
Yeah.
You know, I think it's a bit of a controversial question, this, but how do you see AI improving the advertising industry, but also do you see it having any kind of impact on the human workforce and the human element of agency work or the brand work?
I feel that and this is my belief, because there being this saying that AI is gonna take over the world and we won't need a real person creative director in the future, only an AI creative director. I actually don't think that's the case. But I do believe there will be one day the composition of the team will involve someone that's not a real person but an AI. That will make the whole thing of the original creativity generated by human emotion and brands a lot better, with the fact that all the data predictive, the interpretation of insights can help to create that connected force. And with the humanity and with the data and the science, I think that's the way to create better ideas. So I feel that, you know, if you don't embrace AI, then you'll be threatened by it because you don't know how to include that in the creative process. But while you can, and while you experiment the way to include them as part of the team, actually you make your organization a much stronger organization in the creative industry. And that's what we're trying to do at Isobar. We believe that we can make friends with AI to ensure that we're always on the game to create the best creativity for our clients.
Sounds like a good plan. So we've had a couple of questions through. If you do have any questions for Jean, then do send them through. We're going to do our best to answer them for you. So we've got one question through from Aditya. How will AI have a bigger impact on how consumers interact with brands? So for example, chatbots and voice recognition and how that changes the way that we, you know, converse with brands, for example.
I think that's an excellent question. Actually, I think chatbox is an early example of how customer service will be improved and create a different experience between a brand with consumer. We had a lot of experiment. Actually, we launched our ISOBot, our own chatbox, to create the conversation to ensure that we actually service the customer in the right way. I think there are a lot of areas in the journey and the possibility of AI that AI will have that impact. And the key thing is really the new interface that can be empowered by AI to connect brand and consumer. So voice recognition, natural language processing, and chatbots are just early examples of how this can happen. So this is going to be such an interesting place and innovating ideas in this area, which is create the competitive advantage for any brand to work with their customers.
Brilliant. Well, that's a very good question. Thank you for that. We've got another question from Orhan in Germany. How do you get people to be less scared of AI or even machine learning, especially when from kind of classical advertising or traditional classical advertising background?
I think the key thing is to embrace it. So how do you make use of AI, and how can you think of taking the world's computing power at your hand to create a better idea? I think the way we look at it is that we feel that AI can help to automate some of the work that becoming more efficient. So our people, our creative people, can focus on interpreting the data and come up with bigger ideas. I think that's a better use of time than just resizing the banners, for example. So we need to look at it as a useful tool that can empower creativity rather as a threat.
Yeah, I agree. Thank you for that. We've got another one from Tatiana. Does Isobar use data analytics to create its clients' campaigns?
Yes, I think if you're a digital agency and if you don't do that, you're probably out of business soon. But I think the key thing with AI especially is how that evolve data analytics, how that augment data analytics, and how that create different real-time targeting possibility to have customized and personalized experiences that you can really create for your client.
Brilliant. Thank you for that. And we've got another one from Andy. How do you believe AI can unlock business opportunities for brands and experiences for consumers?
I think that the key part about this is while you use AI-empowered tools in the process when you try to create that experience and deliver more personalized and relevant experience, when the tool is part of your journey, actually you can do it today. They're simple AI tools that can be utilized today for someone without a master's degree in mathematics already. It's becoming an application that people can easily embrace if you include them in the creative idea creation process. So it's relatively simpler once you're in the journey, but when you're looking at it, you'll be scared by all those hyperbole of, you know, the buzzwords and terminologies, and actually it wouldn't help you to elevate the experience that you're creating.
Yeah, and I think that leads on to one of my questions, which is, what would be your piece of advice for a CMO or a marketing director who's trying to understand a little bit more about how AI and machine learning is relevant for their own brand and what they can do about it, practically speaking, what can they do next?
Actually, we had a very interesting exercise that I think will be very helpful for CMOs. The key thing is not to think of AI or non-AI. The thing is, think of specific business challenges that you want to address in your categories, and we can actually tell you how AI could help you to accelerate finding a solution or defining the problem in a more specific sense.
Yeah.
So a lot of specific AI can help address specific business challenges. But the key thing for CMO is to be open-minded about that and look at those specific business challenges and how that can create the future for your organization. And one of our clients, for example, Jetstar in Australia, which is an airline, that they're trying to utilize AI and a lot of other tools to conduct the digital transformation journey for their brand. And actually it resulted in double-digit revenue growth over 2 years' time, and which we're very proud of as part of their digital transformation partner. So it's quite easy to start with when you focus on solving business challenges in a very specific way.
So business first, AI second. I guess that's the right approach. Thank you so much, Jean, for joining us. I just want to end on one final question, which is, what are you most looking forward to at Cannes Lions this year?
Actually, every year at Cannes, I feel that the thing that I want to get the most from is, what are the things that the industry are most focusing on for the past and the next 12 months? Because you will be able to see a lot of things from there, from what the clients are asking and what the industry leaders are talking about on stage. So I want to be able to derive two or three key things out of Cannes Lions from the people's conversation or everything on stage. And I would assume that AI will be a subject that people talk about with creativity, but also a lot of back to basic creative debate in the digital age. I think that will be healthy, actually, for the industry.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, thank you very much. If you are going to Cannes Lions, then I do encourage you to go and see this session on the 19th of June with Wei Liu, who's the director of the AI Labs at Tencent. It's set to be a really fascinating session on AI and creativity. So hopefully this has given you a taster of what's to come. Thank you again, Jean, for joining us. And tune in next month when we'll be talking to Visium about what's coming up at Cannes Lions. Thank you.
Thank you.